Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair guys. We'll be doing oil change today on the Land Rover Discovery. We have this is a late 99 2000 model, I think. It's equipped with a V8 4.0 gas engine, so we'll be doing the oil change. I'll show you what you guys need. Okay, if you're using a farm filter, that's the number that you need. Okay, this is the oil that we'll be using, Mobil 1 Super 5W30. And let me show you quick how to figure out what oil you need. Where we live, it doesn't get too hot yet. So right now you can see 5W30 right here. It goes from negative 22 all the way to probably 95 right there. So if you go over that, you definitely need to go 540, 550. Will be way better. You can even go, you can see with 10, 40, 50 or 60. So now you need to get under the truck, guys. Or let me show you here quick. And we will need a 15 millimeter socket or a wrench. Let me get on this side, probably you can see a little bit better. Okay, right there. And that's where the oil plug is. Make sure that you don't burn yourself. It's good if you drive the car for 10-15 minutes before you do the oil change. Always wear gloves, always. Don't ask why we don't. You should, it's not good for you. And make sure you don't burn yourself. The oil might be hot if you drove the car. So if you don't feel comfortable, just drain it cold, it's fine as well. Let it drain for a long time now, at least 5-10 minutes to make sure that you get everything out of it. Okay guys, we're ready to install it. Make sure you have the washer, that way you're not going to leak any oil. Stay with us to see what three things you need to do to make sure you do everything right and you don't forget something, because otherwise you might need a new engine. Okay, I'll tell you right now. First thing is get the oil plug tight now. Don't leave it for later because you might forget. Okay, we got this one tight, we're done there. So if you go under the truck now, we'll need to remove the oil filter. Okay, and let me show you where it is located actually. Okay, right there, you can see that hole. Just get it loose. You might need to use pliers or something if it's too tight. Okay, that's where the filter is, right there. You can see it's already drained now. That's why you always have to use gloves, because you're gonna make a mess no matter what you do. If it's a vertical filter, sometimes you might be able to do it without making a mess, but this one is not vertical. So we're going to unscrew that one, guys. You want to make sure that the seal comes out with the filter. Okay, right there. Okay, you can see the seal is here, so now we're going to get a new one. Okay, and we need to do something to make sure that it doesn't get stuck really bad for the next oil change. Okay, this is the filter now. You need to apply oil on that seal now. You need to apply just a little bit to lubricate it, that way it will not get stuck for the next oil change. Okay, perfect. And we're going to go ahead and install it there now. Okay, and get it tied by hand. Do not use any kind of tools to get it tied. Just grab it with one or two hands and get it as tight as you can. Okay, that's good. Alright guys, definitely oil needed change, probably 2000 miles ago. We just got that thing, we did an engine replacement that was in the old engine. Has about 5000 miles I think on it, and we usually go about 3000 on conventional oil. So now guys, if you get your manual, Rover manual, on page 173, if you open, some models might differ. For our specific vehicle right here, you can check the engine oil refill with and filter change. It's 6.1 US quarts or 5.8 liters. So we're going to go ahead, remove the cap now, and we're going to add about 6 quarts of oil Again, we're using 530, but depending on the climate and where you live, you might need to use something else. I like this one better for winter time. Early spring and summertime, I usually run about 540 in it. So ours is 5 cords, so we are adding about 1 cord from the second jack. Okay, and now we need to go ahead, make sure, okay, first thing, drain plug, get it tight. Second thing, you need to get the oil filter tight. Third thing, don't forget to install the cap. If you do, you're going to lose vacuum, you're going to spray oil everywhere, and you eventually even might run out of oil if you don't stop on time. Okay. Got this one tight. Now, we'll need to go inside the vehicle and we'll need to go ahead and start it and let it run for about 30 seconds to 1 minute probably. Alright guys, let's go ahead and start it now. Okay, our light is still on. It's filling up the filter. Okay, it's gone now. Okay, so I'm gonna let it run for about 30 seconds to a minute. And then we'll kill it and let it sit for about 5 minutes so the oil can go down in the oil pan and check the accurate level. Okay, so let's go ahead, pull the dipstick, wipe it now. Okay, so we can get a good reading. Make sure it's clean. Okay, right there now. Oh, it's so clean that it's hard to read, but it's next to the full mark. You can see 6.1 cords in our case is to the full mark. So that'll be the whole procedure, guys. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and see you next time.